morning. I'm so excited, I am going to twirl my baton at the football game at noon today. Oh, my mother has pulled my hair back so tight just so that tiara stays perfectly in place while I smile, dazzling the community, the school, and most importantly, my mother. But I wasn't smiling right now. I mean, not even close. I'm sitting at the table, staring at the floor, hearing my mom and stepdad screaming at each other from the other room. Typical weekly boxing matches, calls to the police station, visits to the hospital. This was the secret of what we call normal in our home. Now, I tried to convince myself that this was normal, but it was as though I had a ball of yarn overtaking my ability as a young girl to feel calm and safe. Well, I did what I always do. I tiptoed to my room, and I put on the record player and flopped on my bed to my happy place. And there was that voice, oh, mesmerizing me, filling me with joy. A man that millions and millions of women swooned over. See, when I was 6 years old, I met Frankie Valli of the Four Seasons with my family. Wow, what a voice, what a man. He became my Ken doll, and I was his Barbie. In truth, though, his voice was like a warm blanket that nurtured me. It was his voice that got me through the fight. Fears and the feelings of hopelessness. All of a sudden, I am awakened from my happy place. I hear my stepfather beeping the horn. Beep, 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 beep. It's time to go to the football stadium. I grab my batons, my boots. I run, jump in the car, and exhale. Nothing more was said because I knew what was expected of me. And you know, for 30 years, I did that. I didn't go away to college. I stayed local, married a local guy, had two kids, got two masters. There I was, still trying to fix my family. And the truth is, I love my family. And I wanted to be their superhero. But eventually that ball of yarn grew so large that I actually lost myself. I got tangled in all of the threads. Well, you can imagine, by the age of 35, my entire life crashed down before me. My husband had an affair with my first cousin. Yeah, seriously, and married her. Then I had an affair with my college professor. My mother had an affair with one of her psychiatrists, told him off, and had a total meltdown. It was a mess. At that point, I had realized I had stayed a little girl far too long. My journey really began when I moved to South Florida. There, for the very first time in my entire life, I had no mom and no man. I had to become unraveled to find my calm. And that was a really strange experience for me. I mean, when you're brought up in trauma, you're always waiting for the other shoe to fall. And in that calm, something happened to me. I got a sense of safety and courage. I took out my ball of yarn tenderly, beginning to look at all the memories. Wow. My mental journey through my life, I got to tell you, it was really dark and scary at times. And then there were moments of pure guilt and embarrassment. And I got to tell you, there were some things I hadn't even remembered, but they were popping up. As I continued to look, some of the threads were frayed and became discolored. Those were the ones that needed my attention. Some of the knots had grown so large that they were never going to leave. Some others became permanent scars, lasting with me forever and ever. I continued to look at all of these threads, and I saw loops of threads all around these tiny knots. And then, all of a sudden, what did I see? I saw beautiful colors, bright, glowing with hearts and stars. And I thought, oh my Lord, I finally get it. This is my story, and I am perfectly imperfect, and I am human. This transformation from confusion to clarity was life-changing, and I didn't have to change one thing. This was internal. What I realized that I loved my family. I loved my mom. She adored me. The sacrifices that she made in her mental illness. Few people ever do that for someone else. My friends, they were there for me. I laughed and I had joyful times. And the lovers, the ones that I walked over and they walked over me, boy, there was a lot of emotional investment. Even in the darkest of times, wow, what opportunities to learn your life lessons. Forgiveness, perseverance, strength, and unconditional love. I felt that love now more than I ever had. I could stand up tall. And now, throughout my life, when I go through experiences, I let them be my friends. And I say, with new awareness and awakefulness of who I am and whom I am not, sometimes I'm quite messy. It's an emotional roller coaster ride. And I say, wow, as an observer, what is there to learn about myself? About others, about the world, and what I am here to do. And then in my mind's eye, I trace a G and I say, I am grateful for this life experience. Thank you. Now, the question is it me or has anyone else found themselves wound tight, waking up one morning going, how in the world did I get here? Why am I doing what I do? Why do I react like this? Why do I act crazy for no reason? There are reasons. There are. Maybe, just maybe, you need to find your calm. And when you sit in it long enough, you too will have the courage and strength to bring out your ball of yarn and see what has been everything you need is in here. You don't need another class. You don't need another course. You are made from the stuff that made you brave enough to come here today to listen to this presentation, to the synchronicity of all of you. And then when you look at it, I want you to take out those colors and stitch back a beautiful tapestry of your perfect, imperfect self with joy and gratitude. Oh, one more thing. Big girls do cry, and it's okay.